Good morning, welcome to Weekend Today. We're coming on air early this morning to bring you the news that Kate Middleton is receiving cancer treatment.
Yeah, the Princess of Wales sharing her diagnosis with the world in a deeply personal video.
I want to take this opportunity to say thank you personally for all the wonderful messages of support and for your understanding whilst I've been recovering from surgery. It has been an incredibly tough couple of months for our entire family, but I've had a fantastic medical team who have taken great care of me, for which I'm so grateful. In January, I underwent major abdominal surgery in London, and at the time, it was thought that my condition was non-cancerous. The surgery was successful. However, tests after the operation found cancer had been present. My medical team therefore advised that I should undergo a course of preventative chemotherapy, and I'm now in the early stages of that treatment. This, of course, came as a huge shock, and William and I have been doing everything we can to process and manage this privately for the sake of our young family. As you can imagine, this has taken time. It has taken me time to recover from major surgery in order to start my treatment. But most importantly, it has taken us time to explain everything to George, Charlotte and Louis in a way that's appropriate for them and to reassure them that I'm going to be okay. As I've said to them, I am well and getting stronger every day by focusing on the things that will help me heal in my mind, body and spirit. Having William by my side is a great source of comfort and reassurance too, as is the love, support and kindness that has been shown by so many of you. It means so much to us both. We hope that you'll understand that as a family, we now need some time, space and privacy while I complete my treatment. My work has always brought me a deep sense of joy, and I look forward to being back when I'm able. But for now, I must focus on making a full recovery. At this time, I'm also thinking of all those whose lives have been affected by cancer. For everyone facing this disease, in whatever form, please do not lose faith or hope. You are not alone.
Well, let's bring in Nine's Europe correspondent Edward Godfrey now, who joins us from Buckingham Palace. Good morning to you, Edward. This has come as quite a shock to everybody.
A huge shock, Jane. For months, weeks and months, we've had speculation, rumours, conspiracy theories, wild conspiracy theories. And now, as we've just heard, we've got the facts bravely laid bare by the Princess of Wales herself that she is receiving treatment for cancer. In that message, she says that it was discovered following that abdominal surgery she went in for in January. Tests following that surgery revealing that cancer was present. It was thought at the time that her condition was not cancerous, but those tests revealed afterwards otherwise, and her medical team advised that she undergo some preventative chemotherapy, which she is now in the early stages of. In her message, she said it was a huge shock and it's been a difficult couple of months for her entire family. She's needed to take time to heal from that major surgery before she could commence this initial treatment. One of the difficulties has been trying to explain to the three children, George, Charlotte and Louis, what's going on. Let's have another listen to her there.
As you can imagine, this has taken time. It has taken me time to recover from major surgery in order to start my treatment. But most importantly, it has taken us time to explain everything to George, Charlotte and Louis in a way that's appropriate for them and to reassure them that I'm going to be okay.
You can imagine how difficult that task would be, trying to explain to three young children exactly what's going on while the whole world is speculating about what's going on. She also thanked everyone for their well wishes and support, and said she's thinking of everyone out there affected by cancer and telling them not to lose hope as she tries to make a full recovery. It's been quite a start to the year for the entire royal family. The last time she was seen was on Christmas Day at Sandringham. And then a couple of weeks after that, on January 16, it was revealed she'd gone in for the abdominal surgery. The palace, Buckingham Palace, Kensington Palace, had said she wouldn't be seen until after Easter. And then when she hadn't been seen at all, that's when the rumour mill really went into overdrive. There was that paparazzi photo which popped up of her in the car with her mother leaving or driving from Windsor, where she lives at Adelaide Cottage. Then there was the Mother's Day photo, of course, which ended up being a great scandal when it was revealed that it had been doctored and it was pulled down by major photo agencies around the world, giving that kill notice. And then we had this video at the weekend of her with Prince William at the farm shop near where they live at Adelaide Cottage. And it was thought that that might quiet down some of these rumours, but it really only kicked things along further. People speculating about that video, talking about her appearance and what might be going on. But we have the facts now. We've heard from the princess herself in that message that she is in the early stages of this cancer treatment. This is going to be a huge shock here in the UK and right around the world. There's already a big reaction to it. Rolling coverage here in London, and this is going to go on for some time.
Yeah, that initial surgery on January 16, Edward, and now a couple of months later, here we are. Thank you. We'll come back to you very soon, Edward. But let's bring in Royal Editor of the Daily Mirror right now, Russell Myers, live in East Sussex. Russell, good morning to you and thank you for being with us. What a shock this is down under and over there as well. What is the feeling there at the moment after this news has just broken?
Well, good morning to both of you. Huge, hugely shocking news. I mean, I think the world over will only just hear the words cancer, the fact that the Princess of Wales has been suffering, you know, in silence amid all these crazy conspiracy theories about her condition or her whereabouts that have been peddled over the last few weeks. And certainly anyone who watches that video cannot fail to be moved by it. I think she was absolutely incredibly brave, incredibly stoic. I thought it incredible that she thought to mention other people by saying, "You are not alone." I mean, I think lots of people who are suffering from cancer or have ever had family members who have battled cancer will take great comfort in those words. And yet an absolutely devastating statement from Kate tonight. And the people I've spoken to in the palace have almost universally been taken aback by it, that this was something that had been very, very heavily guarded. Of course, the Princess of Wales and Kensington Palace have gone through great lengths to safeguard her private medical history. And on the backdrop of there was, you know, three people who have allegedly accessed her private medical information. So it's been a very, very distressing time for her recently.
Well, you mentioned all of those crazy conspiracy theories, as you call them, all the speculation she's been facing. Why do you think she's decided to release this message now?
Well, it's very clear, and the message from Kensington Palace was, of course, that both Kate and William needed time to take in the monumental news of her diagnosis, but also then decide how to impart that to their three children. I mean, Prince George is 10, Charlotte just 8, and Louis, you know, only 5 years old, so they had to come up with a way of explaining this to them in a way that they would feel comfortable. And, you know, Kate was speaking herself by saying, "I've told them I'm going to be okay. I'm getting stronger all the time." But the timing is key, actually, because the children have not only been told now, but they're on Easter holidays. They broke up from school today. So I think it's all about sort of the family coming together now. We won't see Kate and William and the family Easter service in church on Sunday, next Sunday in Windsor. And I think that it's very much a case of being together as a family over the next few days and weeks.
Yeah. And Russell, how well known was this diagnosis and how did they manage to somehow keep this under wraps with all that speculation over a couple of months now?
Well, it's certainly been kept under wraps. And again, very, very, you know, the privacy element of this is absolutely key. And if you remember the story we broke during the week about the three members of staff at the London Clinic who have been suspended amid allegations of them trying to access her private medical data. I'm told that this wasn't sort of the precursor for the Princess of Wales deciding to talk about it now. It was very, very much centred on the children and them both deciding, Kate and William, that the time was right to sort of share that news with the world because they had shared it with their children. And they'll be together over the next few weeks after the kids are off for Easter holidays. So it's been a very distressing time. And I think, you know, you've got the conspiracy theories, you've got the backdrop of this current criminal investigation over her medical records. And then obviously the pressure that she may have felt in order to impart that information to the world. It's been an absolutely extraordinary few weeks for her.
Russell, in terms of the royal family, it's now facing two senior members both battling cancer. What does that mean the next few months will look like?
I mean, I think if anything is certain over the last few weeks, it's that we are living in very, very unprecedented and uncharted territory because, you know, the slimmed down monarchy, as it were, is looking absolutely threadbare. And of course, the king's was diagnosed with cancer in February. Buckingham Palace announced that he would be sort of stepping back from most duties. I mean, we have seen him sparingly, but he is undergoing weekly treatments. And at 75 years old, that is taking an awful lot out of him. I mean, it's incredibly shocking that Kate is now going through a similar set of circumstances at just the age of 42 and being very fit and healthy. It's an absolutely incredible set of circumstances. And the thing, someone said to me tonight, you know, this is their darkest hours that the royal family always pull together. And I think that that is absolutely key for the family right now. I mean, you had Kate not only speaking about the love and support from other people, but the love and support from her husband, Prince William. And he has an awful lot on his shoulders. So I think he'll need time to take, you know, take care of himself and his family as he digests this news.
So who do we see stepping up then? Who steps in when the king and the princess can't? And presumably Prince William being off with his family as well.
Well, Prince William, I'm told Prince William is going to return to duties after Easter. I mean, we've got this sort of 3-week period where the children are off school and they may feel that the information is out there. They've appealed for time and privacy to sort of take this news in as a family. So, but I still think we'll see him quite sparingly. Of course, the king is undergoing his weekly treatment, but we've seen Queen Camilla stepping up in an incredible amount over the last few weeks. And it's something that she will no doubt have to do over the next few weeks. And I'm told that it's something that she is absolutely taking in her stride, but very, very seriously as well. She is the main linchpin for the royal family now. And it's something she's taking very, very seriously.
The UK must be hurting right now, Russell. The death of the Queen, the cancer diagnosis for the King, and now this. Just explain to us, if you can, just the feeling right now. Shock comes to mind, of course.
Well, absolutely. I mean, I'll say it again, we are living in absolutely unprecedented times. In all my years of covering the royals, I've never known a period like it. And that really does sort of give you an indication of just the last few weeks. I mean, the start of the year has been one issue after another, and it's been no less devastating. I mean, the fact that the Princess of Wales is in hospital, then the King, then we had the King's cancer diagnosis. Then, of course, you're dealing with the backdrop of this clambering of information. And I think, the mainstream media have been very, very respectful and have given the period of time that Kate and the Kensington Palace had asked for. But I think there's a lot of people that need to take a long, hard look at their behaviour on social media. And, the royals are not immune to this. They are people too. There's a young woman who has been in hospital facing this private battle. She has 3 children to think about. And hopefully people will think about their actions and be more respectful about their commentary.
Yeah, hear, hear. Egg on face for a lot of those conspiracy theorists, etc., etc. Russell Myers, thank you so much for being with us. I know you're hurting, the UK is hurting, and we're in shock here as well. So thanks for being with us. We'll be back to you as soon as we can, OK? Thanks so much.